What's going on, guys? This is Sean with Nickel City Knives here again. Sorry, I've been out for a couple of weeks here. I've just been real busy. Welcome 5 Minute Friday in the Knife Shop. Again, I'm Sean Ross with Nickel City Knives. Check me out on Instagram at @nickel_city_knives or my website nickelcityknives.com. Check me on YouTube, Nickel City Knives LLC. Yeah, so check this out. This is episode 3, so I promised you guys I would start to get into some gear. Today, what I'm gonna do is focus on the mill and how it's helped me, make knives and different tips and tricks and things that I found are very useful for the mill. So. Yeah, check it out. Here we go. Let's go check it out. Yeah, guys, so check it out. Here's my benchtop mill. It is the Precision Matthews 25MV. That's Papa Michael 25 Mike Victor. Seriously, I couldn't live without it. Those guys over at Precision Matthews Quality Machine Tools.com. Super helpful, super knowledgeable, super fast and quick on their customer service. I can't recommend them enough. I'm actually thinking about getting a lathe from them too. So the reason why I love this model over the Grizzly G0704, actually a couple different reasons. One, this has a brushless motor and it comes with the belt drive already stocked. So you don't have to do any type of conversions, there's no plastic gears to worry about. It's standard, and the Grizzly shipped to you is, about $13.75 or something like that now. This machine is about $1,600 shipped to my house. You add up the belt conversions if you just want to buy, an off-the-shelf conversion from a third party or something. You're talking an extra $400 or $500 more. That's one of the reasons why I prefer this machine over the Grizzly. The X Travel has, I think it's about 2 inches longer, which is definitely helpful. Not often, but certainly you like to have the option to use it. I use this thing, seriously. I use this for my drilling, my milling, cutting lock bars, everything. I have two drill presses over here. I don't even use them anymore because I have this. And the reason why I'm able to do that with such ease and efficiency is because I employ the TTS system with the ER20 collets. This system is incredible. Now, granted, if I want to do some face milling, which, you're not going to do a whole lot with this type of machine, and that's okay. You can take light passes with a face mill. It's perfectly acceptable. You might get a little chatter. But like I said, I use the Tormach TTS system. It comes with a 3/4 inch R8 collet, and then this ER20 system just plugs right into it. You lock down the bolt, and you're good to go. The reason why I love this is we have this clamp nut here. Super easy to change, right? So a lot of my mills, I use 3/8 inch shafts. So I'm pretty much always going to be using the 3/8 collet. But now if I want to change, say I want to, remount my holes in my pivot, right? So I'm just going to go over here and just grab the 3/16. Slide that bad boy in there. Plug that in. Put my reamer in there. Tighten that sucker up. With the Tormach wrenches, now you can use any wrenches that'll fit. I don't know the exact size. These are just labeled for the actual collet type. So I use 20. They got ER16s on the other side. You get these at Tormach. They're aluminum, so they're not gonna last forever if you're a little hard on them, but you know, they last me quite a while so far. So yeah, like I said, you know, easy, quick tool change. TTS system, if you're gonna go with a benchtop mill, let's say you're stuck with a decision like, oh, do I wanna get the $600 or $800 stand-up floor drill press, and then maybe I'll spend, you know, $1,100 on the benchtop micro mill, or, you know, the one step up like this, or the D0704. I say hold off on the drill press and just save the extra cash and get the benchtop, the G074, or like I said, this one is, I recommend the PM25MB, and spend the extra cash to get the TTS tool system. You can buy the collets separately, like I do, or you could just, you know, buy the whole lot. I think they're like $300 for the whole lot. I mean, you get, I think they're separated by 30 seconds. And you can use any drill bit or reamer in it. Even if it's the wire sizes, not only fractional, because they go, I think it's 0 to minus 30 thou on the tolerance, so they, when you tighten it, it'll just clamp it right in there. So you know, you'll be able to use any drill bit you want. That's trust me, the most efficient thing to do. You don't have to worry about the drawbar and everything else. So okay, I don't want to make this totally about the TTS system, but trust me, when you get the benchtop mill, the TTS system is definitely something you want to purchase also. It'll make your life tremendously easier, trust me. And I no longer have to drill things with a drill chuck now. I just, you know, find the correct size collet, shove my drill bit in there, tighten that sucker up. What I realize is that the tolerance and accuracy for drilling in the TTS system is far greater than any drill chuck I've been able to find. I mean, I've spent anywhere from the $20 drill chucks to the $200 drill chucks. I still can't get the tolerance I can get with this TTS system. And trust me, I am calibrating this thing more often than you probably have to. Speaking of calibration, what I bought is this Edge Technology tool. Now they have the individual, the trammer with the dual heads. I bought this for more flexibility. So it's just, you know, kind of moves any which way you want it. You plug in your dial test indicator and you know, trim your mill, move the head. You know, maybe you have to shim the Z axis a little bit or something. That's, you know, that's beyond the scope of this video. But anyway, gotta have your 1-2-3 blocks. Definitely, obviously, a machining vise is a must need. It's not the most expensive machining vise. It's also not the most the cheapest. It definitely works as long as you get everything lined up correctly and make sure you measure, tram. You'll definitely be good to go. I know I mentioned one thing I like about having the mill in the shop is, you know, I can come up with a quick idea and not have to worry about, well, how long is it going to take me to cut out my lock bar efficiently? You know, what I do is, and I know this is, there's a lot of people out there that wonder this. Certainly the answers are out there, but I'm just another example of, I use the cutout disc method. So I buy these discs here, these red separating discs, 25 thousandths thick. And, you know, I plug them in, I have this little 1/8 inch bar here that I plug them into, throw them in the TTS collet, and you know, lock in my my liner, and then I cut the lock bar out. So, you know, you're cutting the lock bar out. You're drilling all your holes. You're reaming all your holes. You're milling your fullers. You're milling, you know, if you're trying to skeletonize your liners, you're milling all the pockets and the liners out of it. And this thing really does, I spend probably between the grinder and the mill, I probably spend a good 80% of my time on those two machines alone. So if I literally could break it down into two pieces of equipment, it would be obviously the grinder, the 2x72, and then the mill. Everything else after that can come. But if you want to do folders, get yourself the grinder, get yourself the mill. I definitely again recommend the PM25MB from Precision Matthews. No, I'm not getting paid by them. I'm just a very big fan of their product. So yeah, guys, those are some of the uses with the mill. You know, over time you'll be able to see me working on this in action, cutting out the lock bar. If you check out the video where I'm making the locomotive for the locomotive prototype, you can see me cut out the lock bar, do a lot of the milling on the handle scales, reaming out my holes. The other thing that I love having the mill for is, you know, just as an example, I like to make jigs. So like, I make these jigs to hold my my scales in there, and that's how I can, you know, I plug it in there, and I have a mapped out, perfectly squared setup for my liners. And then I can go away and design whatever pattern I'm feeling at the moment to put on the handle scales. This is just some junk micarta. Not really junk, but I don't really use micarta. It's this canvas micarta I have laying around. So I cut it up, throw it in the vise, square up my edges with the mill. Another good reason to have the mill. There are endless opportunities to make any type of jig you want. I've made a bunch of jigs for my grinders. I made jigs for milling. Excuse me, guys. Sorry about that. So not only will it help you in finishing your final product directly related to the parts and pieces involved in the process, but it'll definitely allow you to build jigs and things to, as you get into knife making, you think of ways to make your process more efficient. Typically it's going to be to make a jig, and a lot of those times you can find yourself between, you know, the bandsaw and the grinder and the mill. You're going to want to make a lot of jigs. So, yeah, I mean, that's about it, guys. You know, you have endless amounts of possibilities with the mill. I'm sure everyone can figure that out. Cut the lock bar, drill, ream, mill out folders, scale designs, counter boring is a lot easier. And again, don't forget to make sure you trim your mill, make sure everything's in alignment. And yeah, if you guys have any questions about the mill, where to get it, questions to ask when you're purchasing, let me know. Comments below. Thank you for checking out episode 3 and the benchtop mill in my shop. Cool, guys. Alright, guys, yeah, cool. So thanks for checking out episode 3, 5 Minute Fridays in the Knife Shop. Again, I'm Sean with Nickel City Knives. Check me out on Instagram at nickel_city_knives. My website, nickelcityknives.com. or always on YouTube, Nickel City Knives LLC, and the Facebook, Nickel City Knives. So yeah, that was the mill. Thanks for stopping by. If you have any questions, again, leave them in the comments below. I'll definitely get back to you on them. Hope to see you on episode 4 next week or the week after. Cool. Have a good night, guys. It's been out of control.